हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू संकल्प लर्निंग क्लासेस. सो लास्ट क्लास अल्ली नाउ वर्क एनर्जी पावर चैप्टर अन्नु कंप्लीट माडिद्वी. नाउ लेट अस सी द एक्सरसाइज पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. बिफोर गोइंग फॉर द एक्सरसाइज लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट दि क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विच आर देयर इन बिटवीन द चैप्टर्स. हौदा? सो इन बिटवीन द चैप्टर्स ऐन क्वेश्चन आंसर्स इदावे अदन्न मोदलु डिस्कस माडोण. ईग हियर वी हैव द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम युअर चैप्टर. दे आर सेइंग दैट इफ फोर्स ऑफ 7 newton acts on an object, the displacement is 8 meter. So the force acting on a body is 7 newton and the displacement is 8 meter in the direction of the force. Let us take it that the force acts on the object through the displacement. Means they are saying that the body is moving along the direction of the displacement. What is the work done in this case? So here we need to calculate the work done in this case. How to do this one? For this, they have given figure also in your textbook. You can see in your textbook that they have given a body. We can consider this one body. The force applied on this, it is 7 newton. The force applied is 7 newton, and the displacement of the body is 8 meter. The displacement of the body is 8 meter here. What is the formula to calculate work done here? Work done is equal to, it is force into displacement. Force into displacement. What is the force? 7 newton is the force. Displacement is 8 meter. So 7, 8 is 56 newton meter. Or this newton meter, we take it as what? 56 joules. Therefore, the work done is how much it is? 56 joules, right? This is the amount of work done on a body. As it is in the same direction, therefore we will consider it as what? Positive only. Right? This is your first question from the textbook. Let us see the second question. When do we say that work is done? So when we can say that the work is done here? Work is said to be done when a force causes displacement of an object in the direction of applied force. So whenever there is a force applied and there is a displacement in the body, avaga force apply martiri avaga displacement agutte, then we can say that the work is done here. Okay, no force, then zero work done. No displacement, then zero work done. So force must be there as well as the displacement in the body should be also there, right? Then the next question, write an expression for the work done when a force is acting on an object in the direction of its displacement. So they are asking you to write the expression for the work done here. The work done expression is given by work done is equal to force into displacement. Work done is force into displacement. Okay. So next question is, define 1 joule of work. So how to define 1 joule of work here? See, when a force of, what is our expression for work done? We know that. We know that work done is written as work done. Sorry, work done is equal to, it is force into displacement. So when we say that the force is 1 newton and the displacement is 1 meter, then the work done is said to be 1 newton meter, or it is said to be 1 joules. Then the force is said to be 1 joule here, right? So define 1 joule anta kelidaga new definition barbekagutte. When the force applied on a body is 1 newton and the displacement is 1 meter, then the work done is said to be 1 joule. Next question. A pair of bullocks exerts a force. It exerts a force of 140 newton on a plog. The field being plogged is 15 meter long. So they are saying that the force applied on it is 140 newton and it is being plogged. The displacement is 15 meter. How much work is there that they are asking? So the force is 140 newton and the displacement is 15 meter. So 140 into 15. So 140 into 15, how much it is? 2100 joules. 2100 joules. Therefore, the work done is 2100 joules here. Right. Next question. What is the kinetic energy of an object? So we need to calculate the kinetic energy of an object, not calculation. They're asking you the definition here. What is the kinetic energy of an object? See, we have different forms of energy. How the bare forms of energy there, really kinetic energy, potential energy, then gravitational potential energy, nuclear energy, really kinetic energy and tandrino. Kinetic energy is nothing but what? It is the by virtue of its motion. The energy possessed by the body by virtue of its motion is called as what? Kinetic energy, right? Kinetic energy means what? The energy possessed by the body by virtue of its motion is called as kinetic energy. Okay, then next question we have here. The next question is, the kinetic energy of an object of mass m moving with a velocity of 5 m/s is 25 joules. What will be kinetic energy when its velocity is doubled? What will be its kinetic energy when its velocity is increased 3 times? So here we need to do the calculation. See, they are saying that the body is having velocity 5 and the kinetic energy is 25 joules. They are asking you what will be the kinetic energy if the velocity is doubled here. Okay. See how we can do this solution part. That is, we can write it as the kinetic energy of the object. So we have the kinetic energy is equal to, it is 25 joules. Kinetic energy is equal to, it is 25 joules, and velocity is equal to 5 m/s. How the, so what is kinetic energy is equal to formula? We have kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 m/v², right? So let us calculate mass here. How we can do? 2 ikada multiply madidre enagutte, 2 into kinetic energy, then v square, it will come in the denominator. That is equal to what? Mass is equal to, so now substitute the value here. So values, how we can substitute? 2 into kinetic energy is 25 divided by velocity is 5. It is v square, formula is v square, so it is 5 into 5. 5 ones are 5, 5s are 25. Right, so 5 ones are 5 ones are, that is remaining is how much? It is 2 kg. The mass is how much? 2 kg. Mass eshtanta bandiga namage 2 kg anta bandide. Howda? So what they are asking you, when the velocity is doubled, when the velocity is doubled means v is equal to, it becomes 2 into 5, that is nothing but it is 10 m/s. It is 10 m/s, right? This time, what is the kinetic energy? See, kinetic energy is equal to, formula is 1/2 m/v². This is equal to 1/2 into mass is how much? Just now we have calculated, it is 2 kg, into velocity is 10² right? 2 ones are 2 ones are. So 10² is how much? It is 100 joules. It is 100 joules. Means for this part of the question, when the velocity is doubled, what is kinetic energy? It is 100 joules. It becomes 100 joules. Okay. Next part of the question is, what will be its kinetic energy when its velocity is increased 3 times? So velocity is increased by 3 times in the sense, it becomes 3 into 5. It becomes 3 into 5. So now it is 15 m/s. 15 m/s. So use the formula. That is, kinetic energy is equal to, one by 2 into m v² half into mass estide 2 anta ide. Velocity guest anta heltidivi 15 anta heltidivi. So it is 15². So 2 ones are 2 ones are anta aita. So 15² how much is 15² 15² is nothing but what? 225 joules. 225 joules. So this is how we are doing the calculation for the kinetic energy. Ill nodi avaru nimge velocity double matte triple adaga est ide anta kelthidare kinetic energy. For that reason, first we need to calculate the mass. Yakandre mass gottilla, mass gottilde namage hage calculate madlik baralla. So by the given data, andre velocity est anta heltidare 5 anta heltidare, kinetic energy 25 anta ide. By using this part, you can calculate first what kinetic energy. Aita kinetic energy 100 joules anta bantu. Aamele enanta heltidare, by using the 2 And when the velocity is doubled, the kinetic energy is 100 joules. Next, last part is what? When the velocity is tripled, mass anthu calculate maadirthivi, adun substitute maadi, we can calculate here. So one it is 225 joules.
And one more kinetic energy is
100 joules. So next question. What is power? So we need to define here power. What do you mean by power here? Power is defined as the rate of doing work. Power is defined as the rate of doing work. It is called as what? Power. Next, we have defined 1 watt of power. So how to define 1 watt of power here? Power is equal to, what is our formula? See here. We write power is equal to work done per unit time. So what is work done? Work done is 1 joule and power is what? Time is what? 1 second. Then the power is said to be 1 joules per second. Power is said to be 1 joules per second. Or this 1 joules per second, it is called as 1 watt. It is called as 1 watt. Okay. So how to define 1 watt here? When the work done is 1 joule and the time taken is 1 second, then the watt power is said to be 1 watt. Then the next question. A lamp consumes 1000 joules of electrical energy in 10 seconds. What is its power? So again, we need to do the power calculation here. Just now I told you the formula, power is equal to work done divided by time. Work done is done. It consumes 100 joule of electrical energy, means work done is 1000. Time is how much? Time is 10 seconds here. So 1000 divided by 10. 0, 0 will get cancelled. Therefore, you will get it as 100 watt. It will be 100 watt. Therefore, the power will be 100 watt here. Right? Then the next question is, define average power. So how we define average power here? Or average velocity athara define martivi, total displacement divided by total time taken.
Similarly,
average power is also defined as when a machine or a person does different amounts of a work or uses energy in different intervals of time, the ratio between the total work or energy consumed to the total time is average power. So how we say that average power here? It is, in short, we can say it as the total work done divided by total time taken. It is called as average power. Right? Then, next question. An object thrown at a certain angle to the ground moves in a curved path and falls back to the ground. So what they are saying here, you are throwing one object which is moving in a curved path. Okay, curved path ali move aagta ide, it falls back to the ground. The initial and the final points of the path of the object lie on the same horizontal line. Initial and final points lie on the same horizontal line. Then what is the work done by the force of gravity on the object? See here. Since the body returns to a point which is on the same horizontal line, what they are saying here, here the body is returning to the same point through the point of projection. There is therefore no displacement has taken place against the force of gravity. Therefore, what will be the work done? The work done will be zero. The work done will be zero by the gravity here. Okay. Then the next question is, a battery lights a bulb. A battery lights a bulb. Describe the energy changes involved in the process. So, idu yav question edru mele depend ide andre students idu. We say that is conversion of energy, that is energy is converted from one form to the other form. Aa concept mele base agide idu. Eta yen anta heltidare avaru, that is the energy is transferred from battery lights a bulb. Antandre, see, within the electric cell of battery, a chemical energy changes into what? Electrical energy. The electric energy on flowing through the filament on the bulb first changes into heat energy and then into, that is, electrical energy. So here what happens, chemical energy into heat energy and into light energy, it will get converted, right? So next question is, certain force acting on a 20 kg mass changes its velocity from 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. Calculate the work done by the force. So here we need to calculate the work done. Okay, mass is 20 kg, initial velocity is 5 and final velocity is 2, right? Therefore, we can write it as work done is equal to 1 divided by 2 m into bracket v square minus u square. So, work done is equal to change in kinetic energy anta consider maadabodu. So, 1 by 2 into mass is how much? It is 20 kg. Inside the bracket, final velocity is how much? Final velocity is, it is 2 square minus initial velocity is 5 square. Therefore, it can be written as 1 by 2 into bracket 20 into bracket 2 square is 4 minus 5 square is 25. So, 2 ones are 2 tens are 25 minus 4 is minus 21. Minus 21 into 10 is minus 210 joules. So, what we can say here, the amount of work done is, it is 210 joules. 210 joules, right? Next question. See, a mass of 10 kg is at a point A on a table. It is moved to a point B. If the line joining A and B is horizontal, what is the work done on the object by the gravitational force? Explain your answer. See here, what they are saying, the body is having mass 10 kg. And it is at a point A. It is moved to the point B here. Okay, it is moved to the point B. We need to calculate what is the work done on the object by the gravitational force. Explain your answer. See, the work done is zero. Yakantandre, gravitational force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other. So, I hope you are understanding this, or else with the diagram, I'll explain you. See this. That is, we can consider this is a table. On this, we have placed a book, right? Here, what happens? That is, the book is moving in this direction, horizontal. You are applying force in this direction. The book is also moving along this direction. Here, what happens? That is, what is the work done on the object by the gravitational force, they are asking. See, the force is along this direction and the displacement is also along this direction. By the gravitational force, yav directional ide, e directional ide. Ill nodi. Nimdu displacement matte, nimdein force ide, both are perpendicular to each other. Both are perpendicular to each other. So, what will be the angle here? It will be 90 degree. Actually, so now ili one formula kalitivi, that is work done is equal to force into displacement into cos theta anta. Aita. So now you will not understand this. That is, you don't know the cos theta and all. So in mathematics, we will learn trigonometry. There we have this concept. Okay, ili cos 90 antandre, adra value 0 irutte. So therefore, the work done will be 0. By the gravitational force, the work done will be 0. Okay. See the next question. The potential energy of a freely falling, the potential energy of a freely falling object decreases progressively. Does this violate the law of conservation of energy, and why? see, it does not violate the law of conservation of energy. Yakantandre, ille enagta ide, that is, whatever the decrease in the potential energy is there, it is getting converted into some other form of energy. So they say that there is decrease in potential energy due to loss of height. Same is the increase in the kinetic energy due to the increase in the velocity of the body. So yes, to loss of kinetic energy at the, sorry, potential energy at the, that much it is getting converted in the form of kinetic energy. Right. Therefore, we say that even though the potential energy is decreasing, it is getting converted in the form of kinetic energy. So next question. What are the various energy transformations that occur when you are riding a bicycle? So we need to write here the what are the various forms of energy as getting converted. The chemical energy of the food changes into heat and then to the muscular energy. On pedaling, the muscular energy changes into mechanical energy. So in short, we can also write it as what? Muscular energy to kinetic energy plus heat energy antanu baribod nagili atva. First, when you have food, then the chemical energy will get changes into heat and that is into muscular energy and that it will help you to pedal the cycle.
So finally, it is getting converted
in the form of what? Mechanical energy. Okay, next. So next question. Does the transfer of energy takes place when you push a huge rock with all your might and fail to move it? Where is the energy you spent going? See here, they are asking you, does the transfer of energy takes place when you push a huge rock with all your might and fail to move it? See, energy transfer does not take place as no displacement takes place in the direction of the applied force. The energy spent is used to overcome inertia of rest of the rock here. So here what happens? No doubt you are applying the force, means you are doing some work here, but two, it is not getting converted in the form of what you can say, that is displacement. So if there is no displacement, what we say that there is no displacement means the work done will be zero. But whatever energy you are spending, that is getting converted in the form of what, or that is used to overcome the inertia of rest of the rock. Okay. This is how we can explain this concept. Okay, the next question is, A certain household has consumed 250 unit of energy during a month. How much energy is this in joules? So in terms of joules, we need to calculate this energy now. See how to do this one. It is given by, that is, one unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. One unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to what we write? We write it as what? 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joules. 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joules. So 250 unit of energy means how much it is? It is 250 into 3.6 into 10 raised to 6. So 250 into 3.6 into 10 raised to 6. And it is nothing but what? 9 into 10 raised to 8 joules. It is 9 into 10 raised to 8 joules. Therefore, one unit of energy will consume, means 250 unit of energy during a month, it will consume 9 into 10 raised to 8 joules. 9 into 10 raised to 8 joules. Okay. So next question is, an object of mass 40 kg is raised to a height of 5 meter above the ground. What is its potential energy? See, here we need to calculate. The mass is given as 40 kg and the height is, it is 5 meter above the ground. What is its potential energy? See, potential energy is equal to, what is the formula? It is mgh, right? But what is its potential energy? It is raised to a height of 5 meter. Okay, so what is that down audience? That is, if the object is allowed to fall, find its kinetic energy when it is half down. So we need to calculate the potential energy and kinetic energy both here. Okay, so solution is, see this one. That is written as, we know that potential energy is equal to, it is mgh. M is how much? It is 40. G is how much? It is 9.8. Into h is how much? It is 5 meters. So 40 into 9.8 into 5. It is 1960 joules here. How the? At the half down, the potential energy becomes. So, this is full 5 meter, kinetic potential energy. Half way, kinetic energy, sorry, potential energy can calculate. It becomes 1960 divided by 2. So, what is 1960 divided by 2? It is 980 joules. It is 980 joules. At the half way, the potential energy is 980 joules here. Okay. So, what we say, so suppose this is entire, it is 5 meter, right? So ilena anta heltivu now, at this point andre halfway iddaga, the object has equal amount of potential and kinetic energy. This is according to the law of conservation of energy. So at halfway, if you are calculating, whatever your potential energy will be there, that will be equal to your kinetic energy, right? So at the highest point and at the last, and the lowest point is different, the kinetic energy and the potential energy. But at the mid, it will be same. It will be same. Next question. What is the work done by the force of gravity on a satellite moving around the earth? Justify your answer. So see here. When a satellite moves around the earth, then at each point of its path, the direction of force of gravity on the satellite is perpendicular to the direction of its displacement. Therefore, the work done will be zero. Antandre, satellite yavatara move aagtirutte, circular path alli move aagta irutte. So, whatever the gravity on the object it is there, again it is perpendicular. Yavaga force matte displacement perpendicular to each other irutte. Avaga naven anta heltivi, the work done will be zero. The work done is zero here. Okay, next question. Can there be displacement of an object in the absence of any force acting on it? Think, discuss this question with your friends and teacher. So, is it possible to have the displacement if there is no force? See, the answer is both yes and no. Yes, when the object moves in a deep space from one point to another point in a straight line, the displacement takes place without the application of force. So, space alone agatten thandre, if the object is falling from one point to another point without any force also, it will be falling. Therefore, we can say that the statement is true. But it is no also, because the force cannot be zero for displacement on the surface of earth. Some force is essential. On the earth, if you are discussing, you bari earth ki restrict madi study madta hodre ille nagutte, without the force there is no displacement. But if you concern about space, that time without force also the displacement will be there. So we can write the answer both here, yes and no. Then the next question is, a person holds a bundle of hay over his head for 30 minutes and gets tired. Has he done some work or not? Justify your answer. See, the person does not do work because no displacement takes place in the direction of applied force. So, there is no displacement because the person is not moving. Therefore, the work done will be zero. The work done will be zero here. Because there is no displacement along the direction of the force here. Therefore, the work done will be zero. Even though he is spending some energy, but the work done will be zero. Next question is, an electric heater is rated 1500 watt. How much energy does it use in 10 hours? So, illodi. Itara sum now already madidvi. Illodi new. That is, the power rating is 1500 watt. Power rating estanta kottidare. Power estanta heltidare 1500 watt anta ide. So 1500 watt means how much it is? 1.5 kilowatt. Time how much it is? 10 hours. Aita. So energy consumed is equal to power into time. So power is 1.5 into time is 10. So 1.5 into 10 is how much? It is 15 kilowatt hour. 15 kilowatt hour. Okay. So hence the energy consumed by the heater in 10 hour is 15 kilowatt hour or 15 units anta heltare. Just multiply power into time, you will get the energy consumed. Aita. Next question. Illustrate the law of conservation of energy by discussing the energy changes which occur when we draw a pendulum bob to one side and allow it to oscillate. Why does the bob eventually come to rest? What happens to its energy eventually? Is it a violation of the law of conservation of energy? So, law of conservation of energy antu ellu namge idu enagalla invalid agalla. So, idanna naavu yav tara justify maadabodu nodi. When the pendulum bob is pulled, the energy supplied is stored in it in the form of potential energy. Aita. So, naavu adanna yavaga pull maadtivi andre adu middle alli irutte, center point alli. When you pull it, that is what? Potential energy. When the pendulum is released so that it starts moving towards the right. So yavaga neevu one point itagondogi bidthiri avaga it moves towards the right. Okay, in that case the potential energy changes into kinetic energy. Hauda, it has maximum kinetic energy but the potential energy becomes zero. As it moves to the extreme right, its kinetic energy changes into potential energy such that at the extreme position it has maximum potential energy and zero kinetic energy. And it when it moves from this extreme position to the mean position, its potential energy again changes to kinetic energy. This illustrates the law of conservation of energy. Eventually the bob come to rest because during each oscillation a part of energy possessed by it is transferred to air and it overcoming friction of the suspension. Thus, the energy of the pendulum is dissipated in air. The law of conservation of energy is not violated because the energy merely changes into form, other form, and is not destroyed. So, continuously, when that bob is oscillating, converting in the form of potential to kinetic, kinetic to potential, potential to kinetic, it is changing into one or the other form. Adi avaga slowly resting baratte, resting bandagena agatte, kinetic energy, potential energy, yaldu zero agatte. So, it is not according to our law of conservation of energy, it is not true or it is not valid. Adre ilen agtiratte antandre. Whatever the energy it is spending, it is used to overcome the air friction. So, alene energy ide, adu air ge transfer agi hogutte. So, again the energy is getting transferred here, not it is getting destroyed. Anta naavu illi baribodu. I hope it is clear to you. Then the next question is, an object of mass m is moving with a constant velocity v, how much work should be done on the object in order to bring the object to rest? See here, kinetic energy of the object is given by half mv square. To bring it to rest, antandre enagutte, how much work you need to give? The work need to be given, it should be the kinetic energy itself, that is half mv square antane helabodu. ಸೊ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ದ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೋಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಅದು ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 1/2 ½ mv² ಸಾರಿ 1/2 mv² ಓಕೆ. ದೆನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್, ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ ಆಫ್ 1500 kg moving at a velocity of 60 km/h. So let us calculate this. See how to calculate this one. Kinetic energy is equal to, our formula is 1/2 mv² aita. So avru nimge illi velocity na ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಅವರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 60 × 5/18. ಸೊ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 1/2, ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ 1500 × ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ 60 × 5/18 ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ 20.8 × 10⁴ joules. 20.8 × 10⁴ joules. Therefore, the energy required to stop the car is 20.8 × 10⁴ joules. So direct calculate ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ. Next question. So here you have one diagram. Based on the diagram, the question is given. In each of the following, a force F is acting on an object. So new question nimdu textbook alli nodi 18, question number 18 idu aita. The each body is acted by the force of F. The direction of displacement is from west to east, shown by the longer arrow. So new arrow mark anna observe maadabodu nim textbook alli ide aita. Observe the diagram carefully and state whether the work done by the force is negative, positive or zero. Negative, positive or zero. See this. So first I'll draw and show you the figure here. See the figure, something it is given like this. The first one, the second one and the third one. Right. So here the force is there. Yeah. Here the force is there. And the next one is the forces along this direction. In this direction they have showed. Aitha displacement nodi, idudu ee tara tagondidare, idu displacement anta torustidare. So here it is given. Next, and this is also along this direction. So case 1, 2, 3. Ill nodi, in the first case, the direction of the force and the block are perpendicular to each other. Ill nodi, idu force aitha, idu displacement aitu, both are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, what will be the work done here, students? The work done will be zero. Next, here in the second case, the work done and the force and the displacement are in the same direction, therefore it is positive work done. And in the third case, the force is in this direction, displacement is this direction, therefore the work done is negative. So the work done is negative in the third case, second case it is positive, first case it is zero. The next question is, Sony says that the acceleration in an object could be zero even when several forces are acting on it. Do you agree with her and why? See, yes, acceleration is an object, in an object could be zero even when several forces are acting on it. This happens when all the forces cancel out each other, that is the net force acting on the body or the object is zero. So do you agree with this or no, they are asking. Yes, we agree with this, because when the many forces are acting from different direction, therefore the work done will be zero here, right? Next question. Find the energy in kilowatt hour consumed in 10 hours by four devices of power 500 watt each. So power is 500 watt. So in terms of kilowatt, let us convert because time edral kottidare nodi 10 hours al kottiradrinda now power anna convert madana. It becomes 0.50 kilowatt. The time is 10 hours. Therefore, the work done is equal to, or the power is equal to energy consumed divided by time. So power into time will give you the energy consumption. Therefore, power is 0.50 into 10 hours. It is 5 kilowatt hour. Aitha yesterday device anta heltidare, four device anta heltidare. So each device is 5 kilowatt hour. Therefore, for 5 devices, it becomes 4 into 5. It is 20 kilowatt hour, or we can also say it as 20 units, or we can also say it as what? 20 units. Aitha simple ide. Then the last question of your work energy and power chapter is, see this. A freely falling object eventually stop. A freely falling object eventually stops on reaching the ground, what happens to its kinetic energy? See, and as the object hits the hard ground, its kinetic energy gets converted into heat energy. So first enagutte heat energy agutte when it touches the earth here. And sound energy, howda yakantandre neevu enagutte the object band hit aadaga we will get some sound here, so it is converted in the form of sound energy also. And the potential energy of configuration, so due to the change of the shape or the collision, the potential energy. So when the falling object hits the ground, these all energy will get converted. I hope this chapter is clear to you students. We have discussed all the multiple choice, all the question answers which are there in between the chapter as well as the exercise chapter. Exercise questions. The chapter is very simple and very small also. If you read once or twice also, you can remember the concepts. Okay. So go through it, note down the notes and the question answers and study well. Thank you.